Chapter 1 My Family Kickstart Make a thank you card for your family to thank them for always being there for you. Your teacher will take you for a short walk in the school ground. Collect small objects like flower petals, leaves, and twigs that you see to decorate the card. Thank you so much. A family is the smallest unit of society. It is a group of people with whom mother, father, and children make a family. There are three types of families. It depends upon the number of members a family has. Nuclear family. Father, mother, son, and daughter make a small family. It is also called a nuclear family. A nuclear family can be big or small. In a small nuclear family, parents and one or two children live together. In a big nuclear family, parents and more than two children live together. Joint family. In some families, parents, grandparents, uncles, aunts and cousins all live together. Such a family living under one roof is called a joint family. Sharing in a family. Family members live together happily. In a family, there's a lot of work to be done. So, besides sharing love, the family members also share the housework. Parents sometimes play with the children. Father works to earn money for the family. Mother cooks food for the family. Grandparents tell stories to grandchildren. Caring for each other. All members of the family care for each other. Children help their parents in cleaning home. They keep their things in proper places, having fun together. The members of a family spend time together. They celebrate birthdays, anniversaries, festivals, and special occasions together. They have fun and enjoy every moment. Holidays are special. Everyone is at home. Special dishes are prepared. Children get more time to spend with their family. Tidbits. Members of a family also have a common name. It is called a family name or surname. Surnames are Sharma, Jain, Khan, and many more. In a family, we learn many new things. We share our joys and sorrows with our family members. We must obey our elders. We must care for our youngest. Looking back, a family is the smallest unit of society. Father, mother, son and daughter make a small family. In a small nuclear family, parents and one or two children live together. Family members live together happily. In a family, there's a lot of work to be done. All members of the family care for each other. Chapter 2 Our Body Kickstart Your teacher will play a song for you and teach you actions to do along with the song. The song is called If You Are Happy and You Know It, Clap Your Hands. Make a list of the different parts of the body that you hear about in the song. The human body is like a most complex machine. It can do many wonderful things that other machines cannot do. It is made up of different parts. Each part performs a special function. Types of organs. External organs. Our body has many external organs. We use them in various activities. External organs are those organs which we can touch and see. Arms, legs, and face are external organs, legs, arms, face. Internal organs are those organs which we cannot see. They are within our body: heart, lungs, brain, stomach and kidneys are internal organs. We should take proper care of our organs. We should exercise regularly and keep our organs clean. Heart, lungs, kidney. Sense organs. We have 5 sense organs. They help us to see, hear, smell, taste and feel. These 5 sense organs are the eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. We see with our eyes, we hear with our ears, we smell with our nose, we taste with our tongue, we feel with our skin. Internal organs. Some of our internal organs are heart. Heart is a pump made of muscles. It sends blood to all parts of the body. It never rests. It is placed on the left side of our chest. Lungs. We have 2 lungs. 2 lungs. They are like balloons filled with air. They help us to breathe fresh air and release impure air. Brain. The brain is the most important organ in our body. It helps us to think and decide. It tells our body what to do. It is inside our head. Stomach. It is in our abdomen. Our stomach digests the food we eat. In this way, we gain energy. Bones. We have 206 bones in our body. The hard parts which we feel inside our body are bones. Muscles are connected with bones. These are behind the skin. Tidbits. Bones and muscles give shape and support to the body. Looking back, the human body is like a most complex machine. Our body has many external organs. We use them in various ways. We have 5 sense organs. They help us to see, hear, smell, taste, and feel. Heart sends blood to all parts of the body. We have 206 bones in our body. Chapter 3. The food we eat. Kickstart. Lead Alka to the apple. We need food when we feel hungry. We can't live without food. It is essential for our growth. It keeps us healthy. It also gives us energy to work and play. Plants and animals also need food for growth and survival. Food makes our bones and muscles strong. We eat many kinds of food like cereals, fruits and vegetables. Different types of foods help us in different ways. Energy-giving foods, rice, sugar and butter give us energy to work and play. Wheat, rice and potato have starch. Sugarcane and fruits have sugar. Eatable oils like butter, ghee, etc. and dry fruits have fat in them. Bodybuilding foods. Bodybuilding foods contain proteins body and help us to grow. Meat, eggs, fish, cheese, beer and pulses are examples of bodybuilding foods. Protective foods. Vitamins and minerals protect us from diseases. They make our bones and muscles strong. They are also good for our eyes. Fresh fruits, vegetables and milk contain vitamins and minerals. The diet, which contains each kind of food in proper amount, is a balanced diet. It is essential for proper growth and health. Tidbits. Milk is called a complete food. It makes our bones strong. Sources of food. We get our foods. Some foods we get from plants, while some others we get from animals. Food from plants. Plants are our main sources of food. We get vegetables such as potatoes, carrots, bottle gourd, etc. from plants. Fruits such as apples, mangoes, bananas gained from plants. Food from animals. From animals, we get milk, eggs, and meat. Milk is used to make curd, cheese, butter, and ice cream. Vegetarians and non-vegetarians. People who do not eat fish and meat are called vegetarians. People who eat fish and meat are called non-vegetarians. Meals of the day. We eat different types of food at different times of the day. Breakfast. It is the first meal of the day. We have breakfast in the morning. We have milk or tea with bread and butter in breakfast. Lunch. We have lunch in the afternoon. We eat rice, chapatis, vegetables, pulses, curd, etc. in lunch. Dinner. We have dinner at night. It is the last meal of the day. Take a break. When do you have breakfast? When do you have lunch? When do you have dinner? We should eat food at a clean place. 2. Never waste food. 3. Wash your hands with soap before and after eating. 4. Take only as much food as you can eat. 5. Do not take food from others' plate. 6. The food items should be kept covered so that flies do not sit on them. Looking back, we need food when we feel hungry. We can't live without food. Rice, sugar, and butter give us energy to work and play. Proteins build our body and help us to grow. Vitamins and minerals protect us from diseases. We get our food from different sources. We eat different types of food at different times of the day. We should not take food from others' plate. Chapter 4. Clothes we wear. Kickstart. In the given pictures, the children are wearing the costumes of different countries. Match the pairs with their country. India, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Pakistan. Clothes are our second basic need after food. They protect us from cold, heat, and rain. We look smart and handsome in clothes. We wear different kinds of clothes in different seasons. Shorts, skirt, jacket, coat, jeans, t-shirt. Cotton clothes. We wear cotton clothes in summer. Cotton comes from the cotton plant. This cotton is spun into yarn. The yarn is then woven into cotton clothes. Cotton clothes keep us cool. They also absorb the sweat of the body. Tidbits. Cotton is the most popular and best-selling fabric in the world. Woolen clothes. It is cold in winter season. We wear clothes made of wool. Woolen clothes keep us warm. Wool is the thick and soft hair of sheep. Wool is sheared or cut off. It is spun and woven to make cloth. Some wool is knitted into sweaters. Synthetic clothes. Some fibers are made in factories through chemical processes. These are synthetic fibers. Some of these fibers are cashmere, rayon, linen, lycra, etc. Clothes made from synthetic fibers are light, durable, and attractive. It is very easy to wash and iron them. Clothes for rainy season. In rainy season, when it rains, we wear raincoat. The raincoat protects us from rain. We also use umbrella when we go out in rain. Raincoats are mostly made of rubber. Rubber protects us from water. We get rubber from tree. Silk clothes. We also wear silk clothes. Silk comes from the silkworm's cocoon. The thread is spun into silk clothes. The silk thus obtained is dyed and woven into cloth. Silk is smooth, soft and shiny. It is very expensive also. Special clothes. Some people wear same kinds of clothes daily. This is their uniform. We also wear school uniform in the school. Look at the people who wear uniform. Doctor, pilot, student, soldier, nurse. On special occasions such as weddings, festivals, birthday parties, etc., we wear colorful and fancy clothes. Such clothes are called party wear clothes. Taking care of clothes. Clothes must be neat and clean and regularly washed. Then they should be ironed. We must always wear clean clothes. Wearing clean clothes make us look smart. We must go to school in proper uniform. We must keep our shoes and socks clean. Tidbits. People living at different places wear different types of clothes called costumes. Looking back, clothes are our second basic need after food. They protect us from cold, heat and rain. We wear cotton clothes in summer. Woolen clothes keep us warm. Synthetic fibers are made in factories through chemical processes. In rainy season, we wear raincoat. The raincoat protects us from rain. Some people wear same kinds of clothes daily. Clothes must be neat and clean and regularly washed. Chapter 5. House we live in. Kickstart. See the pictures and write the missing letters. House is our basic need. It is the place where we live in. It protects us from cold, sun and rain. It also protects us from thieves and wild animals. We feel safe in our house. Different kinds of houses. There are different kinds of houses. To build these houses, we need these things: bricks, logs, glass, cement, iron rods, sand. Different types of houses. Some houses are big, whereas some are small. People build houses according to their needs. Kaccha house. A kaccha house is made up of mud, bamboo, grass, straw, etc. It is also called a temporary house. A hut is a kaccha house. Such houses are not very strong. They are mostly found in villages. Pakka house. A pakka house is made up of bricks, cement, concrete, iron, steel, timber, etc. A pakka house is also called a permanent house. These houses last very long. These are a house made of stones. Bungalow, multi-storied building. There are some other kinds of houses which are not so common. Caravan. Gypsies live in houses on wheels called caravans. A caravan is a portable house which moves on wheels. There are some other kinds of houses which are not so common. It can be parked anywhere. Tent. A tent is also a portable house. It is made of cloth. It can be folded and packed easily. Soldiers and NCC cadets live in it. Houseboat. A houseboat is a floating house in a lake. We can see houseboats in Kashmir. Igloo. An igloo is a house made of snow. It is found in regions where there is snow all the year round. People who live in igloos are called Eskimos. Stilt house. A house built on stilt is called a stilt house. It is made at places of very high rainfall. Building a house. Many people help in building a house. An architect draws the plan of a house. A mason lays the bricks. A carpenter makes windows, doors, cupboards, etc. A plumber fits water pipes, taps, etc. An electrician fits electric wires, switches, lights, fans, etc. A painter paints the house. A clean house. A house should always be kept neat and clean. It keeps us happy. We should take good care of a house. For that, we should sweep and mop the floor every day. Wash the curtains and other covers regularly. Dust the furniture every day. Use wire mesh to keep flies and mosquitoes away. Clear cobwebs regularly. Grow green and potted plants around the house. Tidbits. A clean and airy house is good for health. Looking back, house is our basic need. It is the place where we live in. Some houses are big, whereas some are small. Gypsies live in houses on wheels called caravans. Many people help in building a house. A house should always be kept neat and clean. Chapter 6. My school. Kickstart. What do you like to do in school? Tick 3, the right circle. A school is a place where we learn new things. We go there to study so that our knowledge increases. Our teachers teach us to read and write. We respect our teachers and obey them. Types of schools. All schools are not big. In India, schools may be of the following types. Kindergarten school. This school is for very small children. These schools prepare children, go there to learn through schools. Very young children go there to learn through playing. These schools are also known as play schools or nursery schools. Primary schools. Most villages have small schools. They are up to class 5. Children learn languages and know to do sums. Middle schools and secondary schools. Schools up to class 8 are called middle schools. Schools up to class 10 are called secondary schools. Senior secondary schools. Some schools are up to class 12. They are called senior secondary schools. Places in a school. There are many places in our school. Every school has an assembly hall. In morning, children pray together there. A library is a place where children sit quietly and read books. It has many books. In the playground, children play different games. There are many swings and slides in the playground. Teachers sit in the staff room during their free time. They relax their mind and body there. Taking care of the school. The school helps us in many ways. Can we help our school too? Yes, we can help our school in the following ways. 1. We should not damage school building or furniture. 2. We should not make the school dirty. 3. We should not pluck flowers or leaves from the garden. 4. We should not shout or scream in class, school building or bus. Looking back, a school is a place where we learn new things. Our teachers teach us to read and write. A library is a place where children sit quietly and read books. We should not damage school building or furniture. Chapter 7. Our neighborhood. Kickstart. Write the name and address of your friend on the postcard given. Postcard. We live with our family at home. The other families that live near our house are called our neighbors. The area around these houses form a neighborhood. A neighborhood grows into a colony. We live with our neighbors like friends. We help each other in need. We are partners in each other's joy and sorrow. It is fun having good neighbors. Neighborhood services. School. We have a school in our neighborhood. Most of our neighborhood children study there. In a school, we learn new things. The teachers also teach us good manners and good habits. Market. There is also a market nearby. We buy items of our daily needs from there. It has many shops. Hospital. A hospital is a place where we go when we are unwell. There are many doctors and nurses in a hospital. Post office. The neighborhood has a post office also. People buy stamps, postcards, envelopes, England letters, etc. from there. From the post office, the letters are distributed to different places. Bank. We also have banks in our neighborhood. We deposit our money in a bank. Our money is safe in a bank. All banks have locker facility too. Fire station. When there's a big fire in our neighborhood, we inform the fire station. A fire station has fire engines and firemen. Police station. A police station is necessary in every neighborhood. The policemen guard the neighborhood from thieves and bad people and also help the people whenever needed. Tidbits. 100 is the helpline number for police and 101 is the number for fire brigade. Park. Every neighborhood has a park. We play together with our friends in a park every evening. Looking back, we live with our family at home. The other families that live near our house are called our neighbors. We have a school in our neighborhood. A hospital is a place where we go when we are unwell. When there is a big fire in our neighborhood, we inform the fire station. A police station is necessary in every neighborhood. Chapter 8. Water is life. Kickstart. Look at the word box. Find the same words in the word grid and encircle them. What is common to all of them? Write in a word. Water is very necessary for us. Humans, animals, birds and plants cannot live without water. We need water to drink, cook food, wash clothes, and to keep ourselves clean. Plants need water for their growth and making food. Animals also need water for drinking and bathing. Tidbits. Water is made up of two elements, hydrogen and oxygen, sources of water. We get water from many sources. Rain is the main source of water. Rainwater collects in oceans, seas, rivers, ponds, lakes, etc. Sea, river, pond, lake. Some rainwater seeps down the earth, which we get through wells or taps. Underground water is obtained by hand pumps or tube wells. Snow falls on mountains in winters. This snow melts in summers and forms rivers. Storing water. Due to poor rain, rainfall in some areas do not get enough water. So, we need to store water for later use. We use jugs, bottles, earthen pots, tanks, drums, and buckets to store water. Drinking water. All water is not safe for drinking. We should use only clean and germ-free water. We should filter, boil, and then cool it before drinking. Impure water can cause diseases like jaundice and constipation. We should always store water in clean and covered containers. Boiled water. Water filter. Water purifier. Water stored in closed container. Saving water. We should save water as it is very essential for our life. Water can be saved in the following ways. 1. Always turn off the taps when not in use. 2. Repair leaking taps immediately. 3. Do not waste water while bathing and cleaning. Looking back, water is very necessary for us. Humans, animals, birds and plants cannot live without water. Plants need water for their growth and making food. Rain is the main source of water. We should drink only clean and germ-free water. Chapter 9. Road safety. Kickstart. Match the road signs with what they stand for. A. No horn. B. Speed breaker. C. No parking. We go out on the road every day. Different types of vehicles run on roads. Vehicles move very fast on roads. Accidents can be avoided if we follow some safety rules on roads. Safety rules. Where to walk? 1. We should always walk on the footpath. 2. Never walk in the middle of the road. 3. If there is no footpath, walk on the left side of the road. How to cross the road? 4. Use zebra crossing while crossing the road. 5. Wait for the traffic to stop before crossing a road. 6. Before crossing the road, look to the right, then to the left, and then to the right again, and then cross the road. Riding a bicycle. 7. While riding a bicycle, we should keep to the left side of the road. If we need to turn, we should give signal with our arm. Traveling by a bus. 8. Wait for the bus at the bus stop only. Always stand in a queue. 9. Do not try to get into or get off a moving bus. 10. Do not push others while getting on or off a bus. 11. Do not play or create disturbance inside the moving bus. It may distract the driver. 12. Never lean out of a moving bus. You could be hit by another moving vehicle or a pole or a tree. Traffic light. The red light means stop. The yellow light means wait. The green light means go. Looking back, accidents can be avoided if we follow some safety rules on roads. If there's no footpath, walk on the left side of the road. Do not try to get into or get off a moving bus. Never lean out of a moving bus. Chapter 10. It's your time. Kickstart. Read this poem. Have fun. All day long, the sun shines bright. The moon and stars come out by night. From twilight time, they line the skies and watch the world with quiet eyes. The sun rises in the east. It is morning time and the day begins. When the sun is directly overhead, it is noon time. The sun sets in the west. It is evening time. The moon and the stars shine in the sky. It is night time. We go to sleep at night. Morning, noon, evening, night. Long ago, there were no watches or clocks to tell the time. People could tell approximate time with the help of the sun and the length of their shadows. But now, we have watches and clocks to tell the time. Hours, minutes, and seconds. A clock has a face and 3 hands. The shortest hand is our hand, and the large one is minute hand. The other long hand, which moves fast, is second hand. The time between 12 o'clock midnight to 12 o'clock noon is called AM. The time between 12 o'clock noon to 12 o'clock midnight is called PM. There are 24 hours in a day. There are 60 minutes in an hour. There are 60 seconds in a minute. Week, month, and year. A week has 7 days. A month has 4 weeks. It has 30 or 31 days. The month of February has only 28 or 29 days. There are 12 months in a year. In a normal year, there are 365 days. Tidbits. A leap year has one more day than a year of 365 days. It comes once in every 4 years. Looking back, the sun rises in the east. It is morning time and the day begins. When the sun is directly overhead, it is noon time. The sun sets in the west. It is evening time. There are 24 hours in a day. A week has 7 days. A month has 4 weeks. Chapter 11. Weather and seasons. Kickstart. Take 3 the correct pictures. The condition of the air at a particular time is called weather. It keeps changing. It does not remain stable throughout the year. The weather can be sunny, cool, hot, cold, cloudy, windy, rainy, or stormy. When the weather remains same for a long period, we call it a season. In India, there are three main seasons in a year: winter, summer, and rainy season. In between, there are two short seasons: spring and autumn. Winter. Winter season starts in November. We wear woolen clothes. These clothes keep us warm. Hot beverages like coffee and tea become our favorite. Tidbits. When it is summer in one part of the world, it is winter in the other. Summer. April, May and June are the months of summer season. In this season, days are long and nights are short. In this season, we wear cotton clothes. Cold drinks, ice creams and juices become our favorite. We like to stay indoors on fans, coolers or air conditioners. Tidbits. The hot and dry winds that blow during this season are called loo. Rainy season. The rainy season comes after the summer season. During this season, there is greenery everywhere. This helps the farmers to grow crops. Spring. Between winter and summer, it is very pleasant in spring. It is neither hot nor cold. February and March are spring months. It is the season of flowers and butterflies. Autumn. Autumn season follows the rains. It comes before winter. September and October are the autumn months. This is a short season. It is neither too hot nor too cold. This season is dry and windy. It changes the weather condition from hot summer to cold winter. Looking back, the condition of the air at a particular time is called weather. In India, there are three main seasons in a year. Winter season starts in November. In summer season, days are long and nights are short. The rainy season comes after the summer season. We like to stay indoors in summer season. Chapter 12. Directions. Kickstart. Can you tell the full form of news? Every day, we have to go somewhere or the other. If we do not know the route, we need to know the directions. Direction means the relative location of a place from another. Long ago, ancient people took the help of the sun to find directions. The sun always rises in the east and sets in the west. If we stand facing the rising sun in the morning, the direction is east. At our back is the west. To our left is the north, and to our right is the south. Tidbits. There are also sub-directions like northeast, northwest, southeast, and southwest. How to know directions at night? At night, the sun is not there in the sky. Then, we take the help of the pole star. On a clear night, we can see the pole star in the sky, which always shines in the north. Directions on a map. A map is the drawing of a place on a paper. The directions of various locations can be shown easily and accurately on it. Look at the map of India. 1. The top of the map shows north. The bottom indicates south. 2. The right of the map shows east and the left shows west. This is a compass. It has a needle. It always points towards the north. If you know any one direction, you can find the other three directions easily. Tidbits. The word news is used to remember all the four directions: north, east, west, and south. Looking back, direction means the relative location of a place from another. The sun always rises in the east and sets in the west. A map is the drawing of a place on a paper. The compass always points towards the north. Chapter 13. We pray to God. Kickstart. Here are four friends. They go to different places to worship. Connect them to their places of worship. We all belong to different religions. We pray different gods at different places. Let's meet Abhi, Shan, Gurdeep and Joy. They all belong to different religions and worship different gods. Temple. Abhi is a Hindu. Hindus worship God in a temple. They call him Bhagwan. The Bhagavad Gita is their holy book. Mosque. Shan is a Muslim. Muslims pray in a mosque. They offer namaz to Allah. Their holy book is the Quran. Gurdwara. Gurdeep is a Sikh. Sikhs worship God in a Gurdwara. They call him Waheguru. Their holy book is the Guru Granth Sahib. Church. Joy is a Christian. Christians worship in a church. They pray to Jesus Christ by lighting candles. They call him God. Their holy book is the Bible. We all pray to the same God in different ways and at different places. All religions teach us the same thing. We should always speak the truth and love each other. Looking back, we all belong to different religions. We pray different gods at different places. Sikhs worship God in a Gurdwara. Christians worship in a church. Hindus worship God in a temple. Muslims pray in a mosque. Chapter 14. Means of Transport. Kickstart. Match the vehicles with their wheels. The movement of the people or goods from one place to another is called transportation. Similarly, the vehicles used for carrying us and goods are called means of transport. Different means of transport. Means of transport can be divided into three different categories. They are land transport. It includes vehicles which move on land. We use bicycle, rickshaw, bus, jeep, scooter, motorcycle, car, etc. to travel within a city. Cars, jeeps and buses are used for both short distance and long distance travels. Trucks are used for the movement of goods from one place to another. For long distance, a passenger train is a very good option. The journey is fast and comfortable. Train is the fastest means of land transport. Water transport. Some vehicles move on water. These are means of water transport. Boats, ship, steamer and canoes are common means of water transport. Tidbits. Submarine is a vessel that travels underwater, but it is more of a defense vessel. Air transport. Air transport is the fastest way to go anywhere. To go over a long distance, we use aeroplanes. A helicopter is used to travel short distances. It can carry a few people. Aeroplane, helicopter. Animals in transport. In ancient times, people did not have vehicles. They had to travel on foot. Later, they used animals to travel from one place to another. Much later, they invented the wheel. Camels are called the ship of the desert. They are called so because they can go on for days without food and water. They also cover very long distances. Bullock carts are used in villages for traveling and carrying goods. Looking back, the movement of the people or goods from one place to another is called transportation. Means of transport can be land, water, and air. Some vehicles move on water. These are means of water transport. Air transport is the fastest way to go anywhere. Camels are called the ship of the desert. Chapter 15. Festivals are fun. Kickstart. Students of class 2 of a school have decided to give gifts to poor street children during a festival. Color the petals that have things they should offer as gifts. India is called the land of festivals. Festivals are a time of fun and joy. Religious festivals are celebrated in India. People celebrate festivals as per their beliefs. Let us read about some religious festivals. Diwali. Diwali is celebrated after 20 days of Dashera. It is celebrated to mark the return of Lord Rama to Ayodhya after killing Ravana. It is also called the Festival of Lights. People clean and decorate their houses. They lit candles, diyas, bulbs, etc. Children light fireworks and crackers. Goddess Lakshmi and Lord Ganesha are worshipped on this day. Dashera. It is celebrated to mark the victory of Lord Rama over the demon king Ravana. It is also known as Vijayadashmi. On this day, effigies of Ravana, his brother Kumbhakarna and his son Meghnad are burnt. Holi. Holi is celebrated in spring season. It is also known as the Festival of Colors. On this day, people enjoy throwing colored water on each other. There is a lot of singing and dancing on drum beats on the streets. Gujia is the special sweet dish of this festival. Eid. Eid comes after Ramzan, the month of fasting. People wear new clothes. Prayers are offered in mosques. A special dish called sevaiya is prepared. Alms are given to the poor. Christmas. Christmas is celebrated every year on 25th December, on the birthday of Jesus Christ. On this day, churches are decorated with lights. People decorate Christmas trees in their homes. They sing carols and hymns. Santa Claus brings gifts for children at night. People give gifts to each other. Gurupurab. Gurupurab is the festival of Sikhs. It is celebrated to mark the birthdays of the 10 Sikh Gurus. On this day, people visit the decorated Gurudwaras. Processions are taken out and langars or community feasts are organized. Harvest festivals. A harvest festival is an annual celebration that takes place around the time of the main harvest of a given region. Pongal. Pongal is a harvest festival celebrated during the Malayalam month of Chinjam, August-September, for 10 days. It also marks the commemoration of Vamana Avatar of God Vishnu and homecoming of King Mahabali. Pugalams, rangoli made of flowers, Onam Sadhya, a special feast, and snake boat races are the attractions of this festival. National festivals. National festivals are the festivals celebrated by the entire country. They bind the people in a thread of unity. We have holidays on these festivals. Republic Day. The Republic Day is celebrated on 26th January every year. On this day in 1950, India became a republic. The main function of the Republic Day is the parade at Rajpath in New Delhi, the President of India hoists the national flag. He also takes the salute. Thousands of people watch it. Independence Day. India became free from British rule on 15th August 1947. We celebrate this day as the Independence Day. Our Prime Minister hoists the national flag at Red Fort in New Delhi. He salutes the country by saying Jai Hind. He also gives the message to the nation. Gandhi Jayanti. Gandhi Jayanti is celebrated throughout the country on 2nd October every year. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, popularly known as Bapu and Gandhiji, was born on this day in 1869 at Porbandar in Gujarat. Gandhiji played an important role in India's freedom movement. He gave us the principles of Satyagraha and non-violence, Ahimsa. Looking back, India is called the land of festivals. Festivals are a time of fun and joy. In religious festivals, people celebrate their festivals as per their beliefs. A harvest festival is an annual celebration that takes place around the time of the main harvest of a given region. National festivals are the festivals celebrated by the entire country. Chapter 16. Good Manners. Kickstart. Draw a poster on good manners in the space provided below. Good manners and good habits make everyone love us. Good manners go with good habits. Our parents teach us good manners. We also learn them in school. Good manners at home. We should always say please when we ask someone for something. We should say thank you when we get something. We should say sorry when we hurt someone. We should always say welcome when someone says thanks to us. Welcome. When we get up in the morning, we should say good morning to everyone. We should say good night to everyone before going to bed at night. Good manners at school. We should always wear neat and clean school uniform. We should always reach the school on time. We should respect and obey our teachers. We should go for the assembly in a line. We should not fight with our classmates. We should not talk in the library. We should not throw garbage on the floor. We should keep our school neat and clean. We should share our lunch with our classmates. We should complete our homework on time. Tidbits. Thank you, please, and sorry are said to be magical words. Looking back, good manners and good habits make everyone love us. We should say thank you when we get something. We should always say welcome when someone says thanks to us. We should always wear neat and clean school uniform. We should complete our homework on time. Chapter 17. Gautam Buddha. Kickstart. Identify the name. Gautam Buddha was born to King Shuddhodana of Kapilavastu and his queen Mahamaya. His childhood's name was Siddhartha. Prince Siddhartha was a very special child, handsome, intelligent, and most of all kind. He had a cousin named Devadatta. Siddhartha and Devadatta used to play together. One day, Siddhartha was sitting near a pond. He was watching the swans. All of a sudden, a swan fell at his feet. The swan was hit by an arrow. Siddhartha picked up the swan and drew the arrow out of the wound. He dressed its wound and patted it. After a while, Devadatta came running there. He said to Siddhartha, "It is my swan. Give it to me." But Siddhartha refused and said, "This swan is not yours. This is mine, as I've saved its life." Devadatta became angry. He asked Siddhartha to take the help of the king. They both went to the king. Both were not ready to give up the swan. The king heard their plead. The king gave his judgment in Siddhartha's favor and said, "Siddhartha has more right on the swan than Devadatta, because a rescuer is greater than the killer." Later, Siddhartha became a sage and was known as Gautam Buddha. He was the founder of Buddhism. His followers are known as Buddhists. Chapter 18, Mother Teresa. Kickstart. Can you name this great woman? Mother Teresa was born on 26 August 1910 in Skopje, Yugoslavia. Her original name was Agnes Gongza Bojagziu. She became a nun at a very young age of 18. She came to India and became a teacher at St. Mary's High School, Kolkata. While teaching, she decided to serve God. She began to look after the sick, dying, hungry, and homeless people. After some time, she left the convent and started the Missionaries of Charity. Later on, she founded the Nirmal Hriday in 1952, where very ill people could die in peace. Then she set up a home for homeless children. She called it Shishu Bhavan. She devoted her entire life in serving people. Mother Teresa won many awards for her work. She was awarded the Padma Shri in 1962 for her services to the people of India. She got the Nobel Peace Prize in 1979. She was awarded Bharat Ratna in 1980. Mother Teresa died on 5 September 1997 at Kolkata. Today, the Missionaries of Charity consists of over 4,000 nuns. The organization so far has expanded its wings to over 125 countries. The aim of the Missionaries of Charity is to provide care and support to the sick, mentally ill, aged, sufferers from incurable diseases, and homeless children. The Missionaries of Charity has opened around 20 homes in Kolkata, including a school for street children. Mother Teresa looked after everyone as a mother would look after her child. Her life teaches us that we must love others with a pure heart. Tidbits. Mother Teresa has been beautified by the Catholic Church. This is a step on the way to becoming a saint. She is now called Blessed Teresa of Calcutta.